Last week, we visited with you on the Cow-Calf Corner about the impact of an Oklahoma heat dome might have on reproductive capabilities of your cow herd. I thought this week and again next week we'd go into more detail about what impacts these high ambient temperatures have on cattle. First of all, this week, let's look at the male side, or the impact of consistent hot summer days might have on bull and bull fertility. Research has been done for a number of years, clear back into the 60s, but more recently here in Oklahoma, some work was done in the late 70s, early 80s, looking specifically at the impact of heat stress on bulls and bull fertility. If you look at this particular graphic, this shows basically what happens when a set of bulls, half of which are left in a normal, very comfortable 73 degree environment over the 16 week period of this study, compared with the other half of the bulls that were exposed to each day 8 hours of 95 degrees, and then the other 16 hours of the day they had roughly 87 degrees around them. Those that had that hot temperature consistently for 8 weeks, you can see what happens to their semen quality and therefore the bull fertility. It drops consistently from having semen motility of up around 75%, clear down to less than 50%. Once those bulls were put back into a very comfortable 73 degree environment, it took them 8 more weeks to return to normal fertility as compared to their counterparts that were left in that comfortable environment. So this tells me again that we want to really think about breeding seasons for cattle in Oklahoma. From the bull side, we know that heat stress can reduce bull fertility and have a real impact on the percentage of cows that get bred in that period of time. Plus, if we have that heat stress that causes some insult to that bull, then it's going to take another 8 weeks for him to return to total normalcy in terms of his fertility. I'll emphasize to you that this is not an all or none situation. It's a change in the percentage of the cows that these bulls get bred in that particular period of time, but it's a percentage that goes in the wrong direction and can certainly affect our bottom line. Hey, we look forward to visiting with you again next week as we'll visit more about the impact of heat stress on beef cattle here in Oklahoma.